Hello my friends, welcome to my channel. I am so excited to do this video because of how much I'm excited to share my thoughts about this product. This is like a really exciting discovery for me. Actually, I saw this little like a video clip or reel or something like that on the Laura Geller's Instagram page, and I was like, I have to try this product. And turns out it's a foundation. So this is kind of like my very first time trying out a foundation. It's not like a very heavy duty foundation. It's a powder foundation and it's a baked powder foundation. So there are two kinds of foundation that I got in two different shades. So I have like four products to show you guys. These are called, so the first product is Balance and Brighten. Hang on, where are all the boxes? Okay, I got it. The boxes are so dirty because I bought it few weeks ago, and I've been constantly, and I'm literal sense, in the literal sense, constantly been using them, guys. So this is Brighten, Balance and Brighten. So that's a smaller one. And then we have Balance and Glow, which is the bigger one. So both are baked products and both are around the 35 price range. I got them both on Amazon. I believe they have like 8 shades or something. So I got 2 shades because I wasn't sure which one is perfect. First I got the deep shade, but when I put it on, anyways, I'll talk about that in a few seconds, few minutes. So I got the shade tan. I got 2 of these. So I got the Balance and Glow and the Balance and Brighten in tan, and then I got deep, both the two foundations in deep. So I have like 4 products to show you guys. Both products are made in Italy, and you get I think the Balance and Brighten is the one without the shimmer. So that in that you get 9 grams of product, and the Balance and Glow, which is very similar to I wouldn't say very similar, to be honest, similar, right, to the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. Definitely want to also compare that and show you, and like to swatch and show you guys and tell my comparison about how they differ and everything. So that is 8 grams. So you in the Glow foundation, you get 1 gram lesser compared to the Brighten foundation, but this one looks smaller. This one looks smaller. Let me quickly show you. This is the Brighten foundation. This is the Glow foundation. So you actually get 1 gram less in this compared to this, but it kind of looks, this one looks smaller. And both, like I said, are made in Italy, and the price is not crazy at all. It's like around 30s. It's in 30s price range. And there's I know I told you guys I got the shade deep and tan. There's actually a shade darker than deep. So if you feel your skin tone might need a deeper shade than the shade deep, there is a shade, I think, deeper than this. I think it's called deep dark, I'm not sure. So there is a shade deeper than this to fit complexions darker. So anyways, I have all the powder. I have 4 of the powders on my face. So definitely stick around to check the get ready portion of the video. And then I have a cream and my highlighter. Look at my cheeks, how glowy it looks. On my cheeks, I actually have the Glow foundation in the shade tan because I am applying it in the high points of my cheeks. So I wanted to put like a lighter product. So it's not lighter, to be honest, it's not lighter. But I wanted to put at least comparatively between deep and tan. Tan is lighter. So I wanted to put that in the high points of my cheeks, and look at that glow. So you can definitely, I also have this, I use like a big fluffy brush to put it all over my face. So it's not, my face is not glowy like this, but I use like a denser brush like this to just pick up some product and like apply it in a concentrated way in the high points of my cheeks, and I love it. Look at that. It's like so beautiful. I swear this is gonna look beautiful on all skin types, all ages. On matured skin, it's gonna look so good, guys. This does not settle in the lines of my face at all. I would say after like 6 hours of wear, if I like take a closer look, very little product is up, like sinks in the lines of my laugh lines. But otherwise, that's the only lines I basically have on my face. I don't really have a lot of lines on my forehead, To be honest, just my laugh lines is what I have like the puzzle, and also down here. But I don't see any products like sunk in there in the lines underneath my eyes, but just a little bit in the laugh lines. But if I just like tap, 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 just blend it out, it just disappears. The wear time is like really, really, really amazing for being such a sheer pro. It's not full coverage for sure, but you can see in the demo portion, you'd see me completely without makeup. I think I just have foundation. I'm sorry, I just have like sunscreen. I had like a moisturizer, and then on top of that, I just have sunscreen. You see, like, you probably be able to see the sunscreen. It's a physical sunscreen, so no white cast or anything, but you can tell I'm wearing sunscreen. So, and then on top of that, I put both. First, I put the brighten, and then I put the glow, and then you'd be able to see how it like covers. I'm telling you, definitely take a look at the demo portion of the video, and the longevity is amazing, and it just makes your skin so smooth and just evens and brightens, and I'm over the moon about this product. I think everybody should try it. At least give it a try. It's on Amazon, and I think it's on Amazon Prime, so the product reached me really, really quickly, and I was able to, yeah. If you don't like it, you can definitely return it very quickly. So let's get into the swatches. I've been like talking. I always get into swatches quickly, but I really wanted to rave about them, sing its praises, to be honest, because I am just like so, like I said, so excited to try this product. And also, so this is tan. I personally feel tan was like good for me because of all the yellow in here, but that is what it looks like. So that's tan. That's what tan looks like. And then this is deep. So the brighten one is the one that doesn't have shimmer at all. No shimmer, but it's very skin-like. So that is deep. I know the color on my hand is very different compared to, not very different of course, but you know, it's a little different. You probably have to match it with my skin on the face, so I'm just like showing it to you, and you can hardly see it, to be honest. You definitely need like a demo, I think. So personally for me, I thought the tan was more suitable for me, but I don't know, you guys take a look at the demo section and tell me which one looks like the best on my skin. When it comes to this Brighten Foundation has shimmer. I can see the tiny, tiny shimmer. It's very visible. It is quite visible. So I tried applying this by itself. This is deep. I tried applying this by itself on the face, just meaning when I was just like playing around with the product, I put like moisturizer and then put this all over the face. It was pretty shiny. I probably won't wear this by itself. I would use it as like a topper for sure. Look at that. That is deep. So this is deep. When it comes to the Brighten found Glow Foundation, I'm sorry. When it comes to the Glow Foundation, which has a shimmer in it, both deep and tan looks, I would say, either this or that, to be honest. So, hang on, let me just do a good swatch. So deep and then tan. I think this is when I really swatch it, you can see that this is slightly lighter than that. Yeah, you can tell. So I have this on the as a highlighter today. When I first put it on, you don't really see it, but actually after it sets, it's kind of like become one with my skin, and you can see it really, really glow. It's like so glossy. Look at that. And I also like applied a cream blush on top of this powder foundation. I put after applying all four powders on my face, I put this Mario's cream blush, and it did not disturb the foundation. It did not disturb those four layers of powder underneath. It just went on well. I don't see any separation or anything like that. I am so beyond impressed, guys. I really, really like it. Definitely give this product a try. So what else? Is there something else that I wanted to say? I don't think so. Hang on. Before we head over to the demo section, I definitely want to like give showcase also the hourglass powders. I will be right back. All right, guys. I have the hourglass radiant light found lighting powder. This is my third. I believe this is my third one. I'm telling you, I am a die-hard fan of these powders. It's like I made a vow I would never stop buying this because of how incredible this product looks on the skin. This is also like a finishing powder, like a topper. After you finish everything, I would just like, after all of this, like highlighter and blush, I would just take a big fluffy brush like this and just like sweep it all over the cheeks. It kind of like sets it and just like melts everything together and melts also the makeup with this glowy powder, and just like it gives like a very beautiful like candlelight soft glow radiant skin. Basically looks like what I have on right now, but this has zero coverage. This doesn't give you any kind of coverage. And I feel this is kind of less glowy when you compare it with the Laura Geller one. This is kind of less glowy and less subtle. This is like kind of like darker. I feel this is more golden. Look at that. These powders, this is more golden, while these two are not that golden. And so this is a darker shade that Hourglass has. Hourglass definitely has like a problem with shade range. This is the darker shade. But if you think about it, it has like, it doesn't have any kind of like coverage. It doesn't really give you any kind of like I said, coverage or any kind of tint, to be honest. So I think people with like even much darker skin tone than me, I'm just making a guess, to be honest. I could be very wrong. I haven't like seen anybody with darker skin tones like really, really use it and like showcase it online. So I don't know. I could be very wrong, to be honest. So, but for me, people with my complexion can definitely use this, and it doesn't give you any kind of ashy look or anything. But it has a lot of golden undertones. So it definitely, I think if you have yellow undertones, it looks really, really good. So, but this guy, I think, is more shiny compared to that. Look at that. This is more like less subtle than the Laura Geller one. And I think I personally like both. It's really hard to pick, to be honest. It's so, so hard to pick. But I feel this kind of gives more subtle look. This is a little subtle than the glow foundation. This is not a foundation, it's more like a finishing powder. So this is much more lightweight, much more subtle than this. This one has straight up this one also has shimmer. You can see the shimmer straightforward, but this is much more expensive. This is $54 and this is like around the 30s price range. Will I stop buying this now that I have this? Maybe. This one I was buying the full price, to be honest. Once I run out of this, I really don't really wait for a sale. So I would just like go ahead and buy it in the full price. But I don't anymore. I don't think I would buy it at the full price. But still, will I stop buying the Hourglass one? Maybe. Like, do I really need three glowy powders? Like, do I? I don't think I really need. So yeah, I don't know. Personally for me, which one wins? I think both win together in this battle of the glowy powders. I think both win side by side. It's a tie, to be honest. So yeah, that's a little comparison that I wanted to show you guys. And so yeah, let's head on to the demo section, and then you can tell me which shade is like the right shade for me, or which is like, you know, comparably, which is like the best shade for me. Obviously both are, one might be too dark, one might be too light, so maybe, but you know, we'll see what you guys think. So let's head over to the demo section where you can see how these products look on me, and tell me what you guys think. I would love to know. We are gonna go ahead and apply tan and the deep shade. So I thought I'd apply tan on one side and deep on the other side to kind of show you guys what it looks like. So let's just do tan first on this side. So I'm just gonna, this is like an Eco Tools brush. Got it in like in a set. So they come like in three sizes, but the same brush. You see this? Three sizes. They're all like flat top, nice and dense, very, very dense, super soft, really good brushes. So I'm just going to take this, and I got the product, and just gonna stamp it on my skin. This is tan, and I'm going to apply tan on this side, and then we'll see how it looks. So you can see it, like there's like a my skin actually kind of like looks different from what you see here. This like it's evening it out. No concealer, nothing. This is just like, as I said, moisturizer and sunscreen. So this is tan, and I think tan matches my skin tone like perfectly. Like, just like really, really, really good. Look at that. It looks really good. I think it's a good match. Like, but I'm not very experienced in complexion products, so I don't know. What do you guys think? I think it's a good match. So that is tan. So I'm just gonna clean this brush quickly and let's do deep on the other side. I use deep too every now and then, to be honest. So deep is, I'm taking a little bit of deep and I'm applying it. I think it's a little bit darker than this. This is more brightening. I feel this is more like, I don't know. It has more red in it. Look at that, it's like, I personally feel that deep is, sorry, tan is more closer to my complexion, but I don't know. You tell me. So that is deep and this is tan. Let's apply this. So, yeah. So this is tan and this is deep. So you can see the what it looks like on my skin tone. And honestly, when it comes to the balance and glow powder, deep and tan kind of look the, there's not big difference. There's not like a distinct difference, to be honest, between the two of them. So, but anyways, I just want to put it over them. Over the brighten and balance and brighten, and I'm going to use like a big fluffy brush to show you. And I think just applying this on your cheek itself gives like a very, very, very soft glow. Really, really like it. Then let's apply, that's tan and this is deep. So yeah, that's what it looks like. Honestly, I can just like, after applying the glow, the balance and glow foundation, both sides look the same, to be honest. There's not like a massive difference. Even in person, I don't see a big difference, to be honest. I could just like swirl my brush and just, honestly, I can just like move this product all around here. And it's all gonna look the same, to be honest. So yeah, I like both the shades, to be honest. How many times can I say to be honest? But tan, I feel it kind of like lifts my complexion a little bit, and I really, really love the way it smooths my skin and kind of like, it kind of makes it very, very kind of flawless. It does give that kind of flawless look. And I'm not wearing any concealer. So if you wear a concealer, it's going to like even cover all you. Even this is like taking care of my hyperpigmentation. I had like spots of hyperpigmentation here and there, especially around my mouth area. And it took care of that. I really, really like that. I'm very impressed, guys. So what else? I think that's it, right? I thought I could do blush and highlighter, so I think I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I thought I'd use this highlighting foundation itself as my highlighter. So I'm going to use tan because we are like applying at the high points of my cheek. I thought I'd use go with the shade tan. I'm just using this brush. What is this? Some Eco Tools full brush. So I'm just gonna take it, apply it right there. That's basically what I thought I would do. Look at that. Incredible. Just the softest glow. Just the softest glow. You won't even see the big difference, but it's gonna give that glow in person, to be honest. I can see the glow and the tiny, tiny shimmers. I can actually see it on my cheeks. And for blush, I thought I'd just use like a cream blush. We'll just do like I haven't like done this. This is my first time actually putting cream products over the Laura Geller foundation. So this is from Makeup by Mario, and it does come with a brush and everything. I'm just gonna put right there, some right there, and we'll see how that looks. Just right there. That's it. I don't see actually, I don't see any problems. The foundation underneath does not seem to be moved at all. It's actually pretty good. It's actually quite nice. Oh my gosh, I love the glow foundation as my highlighter. It's like incredible. It's so pretty. I really like it. This is my first time using a powder, actually. I always, sorry, a cream blush on top of this powder foundation. I have used blush and everything, but it's always been like powder blushes. And I'm so happy to report, and you can also see that it's pretty good. It looks flawless, to be honest. And I will absolutely repurchase this product over and over again for sure. I have to decide whether I want to, the next time I purchase, do I want the tan or a deep shade? Because I'm not really sure. I really don't know because they both look just like perfect on me. Tell me which one you guys think is like the perfect shade for me, because you saw me wearing the tan on this. Of course, I kind of like mixed everything together at the end, but you guys saw what it looked like. Tan on this side and deep on this side. Tell me which one is the perfect shade. Personally, for me, I think tan looks brings out the yellow in my skin tone. So I personally feel it kind of matches, but I like deep too. It's no problem for me personally to wear a deep shade. So tell me what you guys think. Which one is the best shade for me? Did I again forget to bring lipstick? I think I thought I brought lipstick. Where did it go? All right, guys, let me just come back in just one second. I'll just be back. All right, guys, I'm back. I got the Pat McGrath's Flesh 6 Gloss. And, oh, great. What happened to the mirror? I don't think I have a mirror. I'm just gonna look at the video and put this on. I am so unprepared today. So I think we've come to the end of this video. All in all, these products are a double thumbs up for me. I think definitely check it out because it's available on Amazon. It's easy to return and to figure out your shade, I feel. So check it out for sure. I am in love with these products. I've been using these constantly, nonstop. Every time I put this on, I'm like admiring my skin. Honestly, truth. I'm telling you, I've been admiring my skin, and honestly, it puts me in a good mood to see how beautiful and just smooth and lovely my skin looks. And the wear is quite good. And it doesn't like right now, I just put it on so you don't see it. It's not sinking in the lines, in my laugh lines. But I gotta say, after a few hours, I'm talking about like 5 to 6 hours, I do see very little amount of product, but it's not crazy at all. You can just like touch it and like blend that product away, and your laugh lines are just nice and clean. There's nothing like deposited in the laugh lines. We just like blend it, but it's not crazy at all. The product is incredible, guys. I will absolutely repurchase this again and again and again. I had to figure out, help me figure out, narrow down that shade, which is like perfect for me. So yes, thank you so much for watching. I really hope this video was helpful, and I really want everybody to try this product. That's why I've put this demo and this review up. So definitely, if you already tried, let me know your thoughts and your feedback on the product. And yeah, give this video a thumbs up if you liked watching it, and also subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys very soon. Bye bye.